colleguinha não deve vazar.
On your own?
I don't like crowds.
Me neither.
Me neither.
Why not? I'll love you now. Must have felt good sticking a knife in that horned fucker.
Jumping and dying. You're heading to King's Landing?
There's some unfinished business.
Me too.
Terminalista.
I don't plan on coming back.
Neither do I.
Oh my god. Gente dói. Já consegui voar. Será? Tadinhazinha dele.
Why her?
You know she loves your brother.
That doesn't mean she'll be a good queen.
A good relationship between the Iron Throne and the North has been the core of every peaceful, prosperous reign we've ever known.
John will be warden of the North, so a good relationship seems likely.
With John in the capital, you'll be the true power in the North.
What are you worried about? John's taking our army with him. Your queen still has
She's
her dragons.
She's your queen, too. Why provoke her? How is that in the best interest of your family or the North?
You're afraid of her.
A good ruler needs to inspire a bit of fear.
The men in my family don't do well in the capital.
No, but as your brother once told me, he's not a Stark. Are you all right?
Vontade de contar.
She wants to make the world a better place.
What if there's someone else? Someone better?
Ela vai contar. Vai na merda.
I'm taking the free folk home.
This is the North, you know.
And the free folk are welcome to stay.
It isn't home. I'll take them back to the castle back as soon as the winter storms pass.
It's where he belongs to. The wolf has no place in the South.
Will you take him with you? He'll be up here up there.
This is farewell then.
You've got the North in you.
Mistura dos dois, né? Mas vou ficar no Norte.
If it's a boy, we want to name him John.
I hope it's a girl.
Só que ele ia junto. Mas é melhor ele ficar no Norte mesmo, né?
You're the best friend I ever had.
You too, Sam.
Indies. Oh, meu Deus. Vai deixar ele. Se você parte meu coração. Ver a praia juntos.
It's not a secret anymore.
Já espalhou, Tyrion.
It's information. If a handful of people know now, hundreds will know soon. Then what happens?
She loses the North. She loses the Vale. Sansa will make sure of that.
It's worse than that. He has the better claim to the throne. The fact is, people are drawn to him. He's a war hero.
If we marry them, they could rule together.
She's his aunt.
I never stopped a Targaryen before.
No, but John grew up in Winterfell. Is marrying your aunt common in the North?
I don't think so.
You know our queen better than I do. Do you think she wants to share the throne? I worry about her state of mind.
We are advisors to the queen. Worrying about her state of mind is our job. We still have to take King's Landing. Maybe Cersei will win and kill us all. That would solve our problems.
Não duvido. What the fuck? Não acredito. Não acredito. Quem foi o filho da mãe? Eles não. não, tio, eu escondo, escondo.
Punk.
They are grateful for your protection within the walls of the Red Keep.
You're certain about the dragon?
I saw it sink beneath the waves.
That must have been glorious.
The glory is yours, my queen.
When the war is won, the lion shall rule the land, the kraken shall rule the sea, and our child shall one day rule them all.
Trouxa.
Keep the gates open, or she'll have to murder thousands of innocent people first. So much for the breaker of chains.
On Sunday.
We will storm the city, my queen.
Your grace, this is a mistake. Cersei needs to be destroyed. But if we attack King's Landing, tens of thousands of innocents will die. That is why Cersei is bringing them into the Red Keep. These are the people you came here to protect. I beg you, Your Grace, do not destroy the city you came to save. Do not become what you have always struggled to defeat.
I'm here to free the world from tyrants. That is my destiny, and I will serve it no matter the cost.
Mas você não pode se tornar uma também, né?
It could be a fortnight before John and the allied armies make it to King's Landing. In the meantime, demand Cersei's surrender. Offer her her life in exchange for the throne. If there's a chance to avoid the coming slaughter, we should make the effort.
But perhaps it's good that people see that Daenerys Stormborn made every effort to avoid bloodshed, and Cersei Lannister refused. They should know whom to blame when the sky falls down upon them.
I have served tyrants most of my life. They all talk about destiny.
She's a girl who walked into a fire with 3 stones and walked out with 3 dragons. How could she not believe in destiny?
Perhaps that's the problem. And there's the problem of Jon Snow. Perhaps it's actually a solution. You know them both. Tell me, who do you think would make a better ruler? Have you considered the best ruler might be someone who doesn't want to rule?
We're discussing treason.
Don't pretend you haven't thought about it.
Of course I've thought about it. Thoughts aren't treason.
He's temperate. And measured. He's a man, which makes him more appealing to the lords of Westeros, whose support we are going to need.
Joffrey was a man. I don't think a cock is a true qualification, as I'm sure you'd agree.
And he's the heir to the throne. Yes, because he's a man, cocks are important, I'm afraid.
What about my earlier proposal?
Os dois juntos, né?
They could rule together as king and queen.
She's too strong for him. She'd bend him to her will, as she already has.
You could temper her worst impulses?
As you have. A Targaryen father and a Stark mother. Jon's the one man alive who might actually be able to keep the North in the Seven Kingdoms.
How many kings and queens have you served? 5, 6? I've lost count.
You've always known my reasons.
At a certain point, you choose a person you believe in, and you fight for that person.
Even if you know it's a mistake.
I believe in our queen. She'll make the right choice, with the help of her loyal advisors.
You know I will never betray the realm.
What is the realm? Vast continent, home to millions of people, most of whom don't care who sits on the Iron Throne.
Millions of people, many of whom will die if the wrong person sits on that throne. We don't know their names, but they're just as real as you and I. They deserve to live. They deserve food for their children. I will act in their interest, no matter the personal cost.
So what happens to her? Please, don't.
I've spoken as honestly as I can. Each of us has a choice to make. I pray we choose wisely.
What happened?
Euron Greyjoy ambushed Queen Daenerys and her fleet. One of the dragons was killed, several ships destroyed, and the Sand they captured.
E aí vai pro sul, Jaime. Viraram um casal mesmo. Vai zarpa.
You're not like your sister. Good man, and you can't save her. You don't need to die with her. Stay with me.
You think I'm a good man? I pushed a boy out of a tower window for Cersei.
things with this so long.
My cousin with my own hands just to get back to Cersei.
Good little boy you had.
She's hateful.
As well.
And so am I.
Mesmo, hein? Bastante preparados. Tô com medo que algo possa acontecer contigo.
Queen Daenerys demands Cersei's unconditional surrender and the immediate release of Missandei of Narn.
Queen Cersei demands Daenerys's unconditional surrender. If she refuses, Missandei of Narn will die here and now.
Qyburn, we have a chance here, perhaps our last chance, to avoid carnage. Help me. I don't want to see the city burn. Help me save this city.
My lord, I am only a mouthpiece for our queen.
Your queen. Her reign is over.
Your queen's last dragon is vulnerable. Your armies are battle-weary and depleted, while ours have been reinforced with the Golden Company.
Vai trocar de lugar com a Missandei.
Tell me you don't care about your people. They hate you, and you hate them. You're not a monster. You've always loved your children more than anything. If not for yourself, then for your child. Your reign is over. Doesn't mean your baby has to die.
If you have any last words, now is the time.
Fala. Que merda. E aí, pessoal, o que vocês acharam desse episódio? Meu Deus do céu. O final foi bem pesado, né? Que raiva que eu tô ainda da série. Mas era de se esperar, né? Que isso ia acontecer. Quando eu vi que pegaram ela, pensei, já era. Sandra. Mas, meu, achei um episódio, assim, incrível. Eu adorei esse. Gostei bastante como foi desenvolvido, né, esse episódio. Vários diálogos interessantes. Foi bacana ver como cada um sente, né, Daenerys tendo que ver o Jon sendo super querido. A galera idolatrando ele. Ele deve ter ficado com um pouquinho de ciúminhos. Eu acho que ela queria que isso tivesse acontecendo com ela. Porque no norte ela não teve esse carinho e admiração que ela tinha do outro lado do mar. Pois afinal é o sonho de toda a vida dela. Que é o sentar no trono e guiar o povo. Mas ela pedir pro Jon guardar o segredo. E o Jon no final, né, ter acabado escolhendo contar pra sua família. Eu achei bem bacana. Eu também não consigo guardar segredo das pessoas mais próximas, né. E aí eu me identifiquei bastante, né, nessa parte. Na Sansa, certamente sabendo disso, não ia conseguir ficar calada. E foi muito interessante também a discussão do Tyrion com o Varys, né, sobre quem vai ser o melhor governante. Dá pra entender, né, o lado de ambos. Eu também, sinceramente, não saberia o que fazer se estivesse na pele deles. Mas certamente não acho justo sacrificar a vida de um monte de gente inocente. Aí nesse lado, é pra cai um pouquinho pro Varys, mas ele é tão traído que não dá pra confiar nele. Mas é o que ele diz, né? Que ele age conforme ele acha que vai ser melhor pro povo. Eu entendi, né? O que ele quis dizer, se é verdade ou não. Eu não sei, mas a motivação que ele fala que tem, eu consegui entender, né? Tanto a do Tyrion, querer ser leal à pessoa que ele acredita que vai fazer o bem. Só não sei se essa vontade, essa sede de querer sentar no trono. E agora sabendo que tem outra pessoa que tenha mais direito que ela, né? Vai cegar a Daenerys. Eu espero que não, pois ela é um personagem incrível. Tanto ela quanto o Jon. Eu amo os dois. Só não sei se eu quero ver os dois como casal. A parte, né, da Brienne com o Jaime foi de cortar o coração. O Gendry e o Tormund, né, levaram bota. Também foi triste, mas o Tormund logo já foi pra outra, né? Eu pensava que era algo bem mais profundo, vendo como o personagem se comportava perante a ela, né, durante todo esse tempo. Não gostei muito dessa parte, mas, né, nada é perfeito. O Gendry, fiquei com dozinha dele. Mas a Arya continua sendo ela mesma, né? A mesma fala que ela falou pro pai, ela falou pro Gendry. Então, ela foi leal a ela mesma, né? Mas eu queria ver os dois juntos. Tipo aquelas tiazinhas que querem juntar todo mundo. A morte do Rhaegal. Putz. Eu não esperava que ia ser logo nesse episódio. Eu tava esperando, talvez, em uma batalha contra a Cersei, mas não assim, né? Foi bem surpreendente. E, meu, que dó do Ghost, né? Se despedindo do Jon. Mas é verdade, né? Ele não ia conseguir ficar no sul. Mas que deu dó, né? Mas pelo menos ele tá vivo. E a morte da Missandei também. Meu, tô em choque até agora. Mas o episódio foi incrível. Eu acho que foi um dos meus favoritos dessa temporada. Gostei bastante do segundo e desse. E vamos ver como vai ser o próximo episódio, né, pessoal? O que vocês acharam desse episódio? Me conte aqui nos comentários as suas cenas favoritas, que eu vou adorar saber, ok? O vídeo de hoje, então, fica por aqui. Muito obrigada por terem assistido. Espero ver todos vocês no próximo reaction, ok? Beijo enorme. Matané, vejo vocês no próximo reaction.